Students, welcome to the today's chemistry class. We are discussing some P block elements. In the last class, we discussed allotropes of carbon. Under that allotropes of carbon, we discussed structure of diamond. So in this class, let us discuss another important allotropic form of carbon, that is graphite is the second important allotropic form of carbon. If we come to the structure of graphite, graphite has layer structure. It has layer structure. Graphite has a layer structure, and the layers are held together by weak van der Waals forces. Andre graphite, graphite has layered structure. One layer is placed above the another. The layer by layer, one layer mele, inon layer mele, matton layer. Itara graphite alli layers mele layer irutte. Andre it has layer structure, and each layer, aprati layers madhe weak van der Waals forces are present. Layer structure and the layers are held together by weak van der Waals. Force of attractions. Prati layer madhe weak van der Waals force of attractions irutte. And the distance between any two layers, one layer innond layer mele arrange madidaga, the distance between the two layers is 340 picometer. The distance between the layers is 340 picometer. And once again, each graphite layer is composed of planar hexagonal rings of carbon atoms. Prati graphite layer alli planar hexagonal rings of carbon atoms are present. Each layer is composed of or consists of planar hexagonal rings of carbon atoms. So prati layer alli planar hexagonal rings are present, consisting of carbon atoms. The carbon-carbon bond length within the layer is 141.5 picometer. The carbon-carbon bond length within the layer is in the hexagonal ring of carbon atoms, they are sp2 hybridized. The carbon atoms in the graphite are sp2 hybridization state. Adare diamond alli prati carbon atom kuda sp3 hybridization state alli itto. In diamond, carbon atoms are sp3 hybridized state, but in graphite the carbon atoms are sp2 hybridization state and makes three covalent bonds or sigma bonds with neighboring carbon atoms. Graphite alli prati carbon atom sp2 hybridization state alli irutte, matte prati carbon atom neighboring carbon atom jothe three sigma bonds formation madutte. The fourth electron of carbon forms a pi bond. Fourth electron of carbon forms a pi bond. So here carbon atoms are in sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybridization state. sp2 hybridization state. So that is in the graphite, each carbon atom is in sp2 hybridization state and makes three sigma bonds with the neighboring. Delocalized throughout the structure, throughout the layer, and capable of conducting electricity. Hence, graphite is a good conductor of electricity. Graphite alli carbon 4 valence electrons idandre 3 valence electrons are involved in 3 sigma bond formation with neighboring 3 carbon atoms. But on every carbon atom, fourth electron is said to be free. Andre pi bond formation agirutte, pi bond weak bond. That pi electron, that means fourth electron of each carbon atom, delocalized throughout the structure, throughout the layer, and capable of conducting electricity. Hence carbon is a good conductor of electricity. Pi electrons of carbon are delocalized throughout the layer, and conduct electricity. Why graphite is a good conductor of electricity? Because on every carbon atom in the graphite, fourth electron is said to be free. That fourth electron is delocalized throughout the layer and capable of conducting electricity. Yes, graphite is a good conductor of electricity. And once again, in graphite, in graphite, the layers are very loosely arranged so that one layer slip over another. So that graphite layers are soft and slippery. Yes, graphite can be used as a dry lubricant. Dry lubricant for machines where oil cannot be used at high temperatures. At high temperature, jaasti temperature iddaga, oils na machines ge use madakagalla lubricant agi. Adikoskara in such cases, graphite powder, graphite is used as a dry lubricant for machines at very high temperature where oil cannot be used. Since the graphite layers, machines at high temperatures, at higher temperatures, at higher temperatures where oil cannot be used. Come away, where oil cannot be used. Higher temperature ಕ್ಕೆ ಲೂಬ್ರಿಕೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಆಯಿಲ್ಸ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ಮೆಷಿನ್ಸ್ಗೆ. ಇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಕೇಸಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಗ್ರಾಫೈಟ್ ಪೌಡರ್ ಆಸ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಲೂಬ್ರಿಕೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರಾಫೈಟ್, ನಾವು ಈಗ ನೋಡೋಣ ಗ್ರಾಫೈಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಈಚ್ ಲೇಯರ್ is composed of hexagonal rings. Let us see. So this is the structure of one layer of graphite. So here the layers are held together by a weak van der Waals forces. So here distance of separation 340 picometer and weak van der Waals forces. Weak van der Waals forces of attraction are present between the hexagonal layers. It's a graphite layers. Between the layers, weak van der Waals forces of attractions are present. and each layer is separated by a 340 picometer, and each layer, graphite layer, is composed of hexagonal rings of carbon atoms, and okay, within the hexagonal ring, within the layer, carbon-carbon bond length is 141.5 picometer. See here, each carbon atom is forming 3 sigma bonds with neighboring carbon atoms. Prati layer alli, prati carbon atom, so okay, 3 sigma bonds are forming with neighboring carbon atoms. Fourth electron of every carbon atom is said to be free. It forms pi bond, and these pi electrons delocalized throughout the layer and conducting electricity. So this is the structure of graphite. Next, so another allotropic form, third allotropic form of carbon is pullerenes are the third allotropic form of carbon. Of course, these are newly discovered allotropic form of carbon. So these pullerenes are discovered by Croteau Smalley. And Kerr. These are the three scientists who discovered the third allotropic form of carbon, that is pullerenes. Pullerenes were discovered by Croteau of Japan, Smalley of America, of America. So these are the newly discovered allotropic form of carbon, and pullerene was discovered in 1985. They discovered this pullerenes in 1985. And they honored for Nobel Prize in 1996. 1985 alli pullerenes na discover martare. 1996 alli muru janike Nobel Prize barutte. Next, pullerenes are prepared by eating graphite under the electric field and in the presence of inert gas like helium and argon. So that is preparation of pullerenes. So here graphite is heated in an electric arc. Graphite is heated in an electric arc in the presence of inert gases like helium and argon. So that is, in the presence of helium and argon, inert atmosphere, by passing electric current, graphite is heated. It gives 6 power. So that suit material, that fruity material, that is graphite na, graphite na, electric arc apply maadi, inert gas use maadi, heat maadi, suit material is uptight. That suit material contains vaporized CN molecules. Suit material contains suit material is formed by the vaporization of CN molecules. So this suit material contains mainly C60 pullerenes, 60 carbon atoms ittakkanta pullerenes, C60 pullerenes plus rarely in small traces C70 pullerenes plus the pullerenes having even number of carbon atoms 350 and above. So that is pullerenes with the carbon 350 and above. More than 350 carbon atoms irthakkanta pullerenes kuda no ee suit materials alli irutte. So it is when graphite is heated by applying electric arc in the presence of inert gas, a sooty material is obtained. In that sooty material, various types of pullerenes are present. So that soot material is obtained by the vaporization of CN molecules. That soot material mainly contains C60 pullerenes and rarely C70 pullerenes, means 70 carbon atom containing pullerenes, and pullerenes with even number of carbon atoms 350 and above are also present. So this is the preparation of pullerenes. Next, if we come to the structure of C60 pullerene. If we come to the structure of C60 pullerene. Pullerenes are cage-like structures. They are cage-like structures. A network-like structures. Cage-like structures. And C60 pullerene resembles with soccer ball. Resembles with soccer ball. Tara C60 pullerene structure is there. C60 pullerene resembles with the soccer ball. C60 pullerene resembles with the soccer ball. So in this soccer ball, there are two types of carbon-carbon bond lengths. So that is carbon-carbon single bond and carbon-carbon double bonds. And in pullerenes, carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized. So it is carbon-carbon bond length. Carbon-carbon bond length. Carbon-carbon single bond length is 143.5 picometer, and carbon-carbon double bond length is 138.3 picometer. Carbon atoms C60 pulley has 20 six-member rings, hexagonal rings, and 12 five-member rings. C60 pulley has 20 six-member and 12 five member rings. So in the C60 pulley ring structure, it contains 20 six-member rings, means hexagonal rings, and 12 five-member rings. So here, six-member ring is fused either with the six-member ring or fused with another five-member ring. But five-member rings always fused with the six-member rings. Five-member rings jothene fuse agarilla, na connect agirilla. Five-member ring fused with six-member ring. But okay, five-member ring does not fuse it with for another five-member ring. Six-member rings are fused with either six-member or five-member rings. But five-member rings do not fuse with the five-member rings. So it is, six-member rings are fused with either five-member rings, but five-member ring do not fuse with another five-member rings. In C60 pulley ring, there are 60 vertices. Each vertice represents carbon atoms. C60 pulley ring has 60 vertices. 60 vertices which represents carbon atoms. So these pulley rings are cage-like structures. C60 pulley ring resembles with soccer ball. What do you think about that? Five-member ring. C16 monomers. So the structure is a cage-like structure, network-like structure, cage-like structure. 60 carbon atoms containing a structure that is called as C60 polarene. So these are newly discovered allotropic form of carbon.